Okay, we're turning on the MIDIBox and we're going to do a quick demonstration of the very basics of the step sequencer. I've got the camera focused in on the left display and we're just going to work with 8 steps instead of the whole 16 steps on both displays. That way I can get the camera close enough so you can see what's going on. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to press the mute button and I'm going to mute all the tracks we're not using, just to make sure there's nothing coming out of them, nothing's going on that we don't want to hear. So everything is muted except for track number 1. I'm going to press the edit button, which shows us the notes in track 1. And I'm going to also initialize it. That's always a good idea if you're starting something fresh. I'm going to hold down the menu button, press event. When you do this, when you initialize the track, one of the 16 tracks, you can choose whether it's a note track, a chord track, a CC track, or a drum track, all with various parameters and lengths. I'm going to make this a very basic note track with 64 steps. I'm going to set the output to my MIDI number 1 output, and I'm setting the channel to number 1, which is going to play the ambika. Over on the right-hand screen that you can't see, I'm going to push the button under the init for 2 seconds. And it's initialized. You can even initialize while it's playing. You can do pretty much everything while it's playing. Now I'm going to press edit again, and we'll see when you initialize a track for notes, it just has C3s on every beat. I'm going to change a couple of those. And we'll put in a few extra notes. And we'll hit go. Oh, before we hit go, I'm going to go menu length. I'm going to set the length of this track. Instead of the default 16, I'm going to set it to 8. That way we can see all the notes it's playing in the one display. Okay, back to the edit button, to the notes, and go. Now while it's playing, I can change the notes. Add new notes. I can take notes out by untriggering them. When I put them back, they'll be the same note they were before. Now, these are just the notes. We're seeing the note layer. We're going to go to the velocity layer. All the notes have a velocity, shown by the little black bar there. And I've got velocity mapped to the filter frequency. So if I turn some of these down, and I can accent different notes by bringing up their velocity. And then the third layer is the note or the gate duration. And we can, they're all set to 75% by default, but we can change them. And the neat thing about the duration is that if we change the duration long enough to a long enough value, it'll tie the two notes together. And if you have a slide set up on your synth, you can get nice little slides. Like over here, I'm going to lengthen number 6 so it runs into 7. You can make number 7 a little longer so you can hear it. Make the velocity a little higher. Or or change the notes. Whoops, note layer. Go back to velocity. Okay, let's go take the slides out. Make everything about a medium length. And we'll put another note in here. Actually, let's make the notes go ascending. And then with some of the things we can do next, you can hear what's going on a little better since you know the pattern. All right, we're looking at notes. We're going to go to the length. The length is right now set to 8, but if we change it to smaller values, you can see the red LEDs are showing what step we're on. And of course, you can go up to 64 steps. There's 9. You can also set where it loops back to. There's also, that's on the length page. On the direction page, we can go forward, like we're doing now. We can also go backward. Forward. Backward. We can go ping pong, which goes back and forth. And that does not repeat the end notes, so it essentially makes an 8-step pattern into 14 steps. We can also do what's called pendulum, which does repeat the end steps, which makes an 8 into a 16-step pattern. There's also random direction, which continually decides to go backwards or forwards every time it moves. There's also random step, where it just randomly picks one of the available steps to play. Go back to forward. On the other screen, there's a couple things that are neat. You can set it to go forward so many steps and then back so many steps. I'm setting it to forward 5, back 3. There's also repeats and skips. For example, if we set the skip to 1 or 2 or 3. Four, five, six. Back to 0. Hit edit to go back to the notes. There's one other interesting screen here, and that's the divider screen, menu divider. And the divider decides how many clock ticks each step actually gets. So if we change it to a larger number, like 24, we'll set the sync to measure to yes, so it clicks in to be on the beat. Right there, synced. I have it syncing every 4 measures, so it takes a few steps for it to sync. Set it to 32 to get very long notes. And you can set the sync to measure to off and it will never sync. It'll just play whatever it wants to when you change the sync. If we change this down to something like 13. Or 11. There is, you can see it sync every once in a while. If I turn that off, it's just kind of free running. Now it's going to stay out of sync, but if I turn sync to measure back on, in a couple steps it'll kick back into on the beat right there. Let's set some durations to slide again. Play with the velocities. Back to length. Direction. Some velocities. So that's the basics of the MIDIBox step sequencer. Of course, there's a lot more things you can do. This is just something to get you started.